At Tällberg, the sky is high. Horizons blue and wide, as is the Lake Sillion. There's one local grocery, old farmhouses, a few comfortable hotels, trains still stop at the station. The Tällberg conversation were initiated in 1981, a process of learning, not of teachings or promotion. This music grew out of the people and their work. The forests, the mountains, and the lands. No composer. As T.S. Eliot wrote, what we can call the beginning is often the end. And to make an end is to make a beginning. The end is where we start from. When Haydn heard Beethoven's Eroica, the Third Symphony, for the first time, he said, as of now, everything will be different. There has never been any plan for the Tällberg Foundation's process. No strategy, no objectives. I dare say the same for my own learning. I think that long-termism, if I may call it that, is a hunger for power to correct the myths of the present and control the abstractions of the future. Tällberg has been meandering without a goal. Never in support of anything, but curious about everything. Not in pursuit of influence, power, market share, or even its own legacy, or to be the center of anything. But try to eliminate limits to our human cognition, to maximize freedom by being totally dispensable at any time, exercising no power, never to become an institution. The game is adaptation, not foretelling or forestalling a future of which we have but ignorance. That search for freedom and our conversations over 25 years led us into the big tent put up on the village commons. We filled that tent with flows of mutations of philosophical, scientific and business thinking, studded with artistic images and walks into nature. The format and contents created unexpected experiences. Did we ever succeed? Never. We asked in 2005, 25 years into the Tällberg process, how on earth can we live together? Soon enough, we made an addendum, we the humans and we with nature. We could not have asked a more complex question. It required of me to stay focused on being unfocused, not to specialize, not to become a reductionist, to ever reach out beyond my own imagination. That is, I tell you, very hurtful. Did I ever succeed? Never. We adapt, we're always in flux. Evolution has no purpose. But some politicians and scientists envision that they can achieve the promised land, a sustainable, safe operating space where humans can survive in perpetuity. This, I think, is more theology than physics. We never arrived at answers, but to new questions. After 10 years, we have taken down the tent, and now we are here in this enigmatic cathedral of science. Lasse Berg published his book Out of Kalahari earlier this year. Lasse is a storyteller, not a scientist. In the book, he revisits his thoughts and the places that were formative to his perception of the future in the 1950s and 60s. What he really says in his book, when he revisited his conclusions of that time, how smart thinkers we were, but how wrong we are. I like that. We have since years voiced the intuition that the times, they are a breaking, that we live in breaking times. Myths as construed by our imaginations, like orders of governance or constitutions, institutions, religious and economic orders, are not holding out to the violent twists, turns and cataracts of the river of time, if they ever did. Myths of orders come and they go, whatever plans we scheme. Humans' ability to think and communicate in the abstract is only about 50 to 70,000 years old. Picasso, Kandinsky and Stravinsky lay bare, or rather rediscovered, abstract art only 110 years ago. Still many shield themselves from the abstract and the myths of our own creation. We cling to what we think, imagine, what reality is supposed to look like and sound like. What I fear the most is to fool myself that I know. The only thing I am certain of is that I know that I do not know anything for certain about the future. Those who imagine the future as a reality often come to think that the end is near. A saying is that one has to think outside the box. I'd rather say that we have to smash the box. I have to smash the box itself. Liberate the times that are coming at us, as Beethoven did, and as Jimi Hendrix did. He smashed his guitar, liberating millions of unsung songs and a new universe of unimagined freedoms. As scientists, technologists, poets, and philosophers also do. Sometimes do. From where can we see this mighty and violent, untamed process more clearly? My hunch was right here at CERN. Expressions of intuition and imagination, art, have always been an integrated part of the Tällberg exploratory process, in which you are today becoming a part of. The uncontrolled and open process of evolution doesn't know where it is heading. How could it? What its results will be and become, and what they will mean. Evolution has no purpose. The question I arrived at was, where in the process of co-evolution, geological, biological, social, cognitive, technological evolution, are we finding ourselves? Where? Have we passed the first 1% units, or 2, or 50, or what? And of what? Is it still dawn, or are we heading towards dusk? I don't know. The times are full of stories of fear, of end games. Predicting collapse has become a rather fashionable exercise. Fear of disasters sell books and airtime. Millions go watch Noah, the Noah film. And who doesn't want to be the shepherd leading humanity through the white, red, blue, green, black seas? I have always been rather intuitively fascinated by relationships between artistic and scientific expressions. I'm not a musician, but I have produced much music. Nor am I a scientist, but I do produce thinking processes. I'm not a politician, nor a businessman, but I have dwelled for years in those environments. I'm neither a technologist, nor an anthropologist. I'm not an academic, thus I can't be cross-disciplinary. I have no intellectual trenches to dig myself out of, or intellectual forts to defend. I have no plan or agenda to embetter the world. I'm not a do-gooder, neither I hope I am a do-worser. If anything, I'm a knowledge nomad. Here, back to T.S. Eliot. We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time. Through the unknown, unremembered gate where the last earth left to discover is that which was the beginning.